So I've wanted to do this video for a while. I tried it once, made it a 30-minute video. Time to do it again. Don't want to make it a 30-minute video. Tried it again. Well, actually, it's like 31. Tried it again, and I got it to like a 29-minute video. Time to make this a short one. This is just some water. Usually, I'd be doing this in front of a sink. Bathroom, or at least with a mirror and running hot water, preferably at least about as hot, I can't talk, as I can manage. At the very least warm for my face, and then I would use running hot water for I use Barbasol, but brand names really don't matter to me. I use what I want, and that's how in which I go about this. This just is cheap and does the job. That's it. But I would normally be using warm. I can't talk. Still, very well, anyways. Normally be using warm water to kind of get my face ready and get it dampened and kind of soak into the skin so that I can go ahead and prepare my face before the shaving cream. And then I would use hot water for running under the tap, or running from the tap, rather. Running from the tap? Yeah. Hot water. On the tap, on the sink, for my actual razor blade to be going under it and then just going about the job. However, instead, I'm just going to use this cup of water, which I just put my hand all over my face and soaked the soaked my hand into the water, so that's why it's kind of not the greatest looking, but trying to keep my shoulders the only one visible because I'm not wearing a shirt right now and I don't have my undergarment on. But this is how in which I shave my face. I usually go with as many blades as I can. This is a six-blade razor. It's a ladies, quote unquote, razor, or quote unquote ladies razor. I think faster than I talk. Yeah, it has the old comfort bits on either side of the blade, so it's easier for me. And for me, this is just how I shave. I try to get as much of my, at least how I shave my facial follicles. I try to get as much of my sideburns as I can. I at least don't let it go too far below the top of my ear. And I usually go across the jawline. Let's see here. I'm not very good at doing this, but some people do prefer this method of turning the blade upside down and going bottom to top, what have you. Me, I like short strokes of the blade across my skin so I can keep with it and not risk cutting giant chunks of my skin out without cause, reason, or want. By the way, don't want. I don't. Stuff hurts. I don't know. No. So yeah, this is really it. I just go top to bottom on all portions of my face. I usually place my fingers, yes, I usually do this right about here at the top of the blade. That way I can feel how smooth my skin is getting as I shave. So I go over the same spot a couple times, maybe even more than a couple. And above my jawline, I go top to bottom. Below my jawline, I go top to bottom. It's kind of tricky getting around the ear. That's usually why I like these bendy bits on blades. It's not the easiest to get underneath your ear because of all this stuff with the jawline jutting out, at least for me. Pardon me, at least for me. But you can work at it. You can make it happen. You kind of wind up moving your face around. And no, that's not yawn. That's actually me trying to talk while I'm doing this and demonstrating. And you do what you can to just pull the skin taut. It still works on. I don't recommend it. But you do it. And this is how I shave. This is not necessarily how I'd recommend shaving, how I would teach someone how to shave, but it is an example of how I do. And the fact that I use my fingers above the blade as I drag it across my skin, as I move it more so, preferably more so, across my skin as opposed to dragging, allows me to also not have necessarily an eye view of, you know, a direct view of where and which I'm shaving. So I can actually shave blindly easier, not willfully, not consistently, not with great expertise, but easier if I'm doing such a thing as that. And it also helps keeping the blade consistently wet, keeping it as warm as possible, which in this case it's not, because the hotter the blade is, the easier it will go and remove the follicles. And yeah, that's it. Now, I've cleared all the facial, all the shaving cream, not the facial cream, the shaving cream. Facial cream is a different one that's for moisturizing and cleansing and removal of dead skin, old skin. The reason as to why shaving cream is often recommended that I've found, the only real reason why, is for moistening up the hair and for loosening it up, getting it prepared and damper so that you can actually move it across your skin and not have the skin itself be so feeling abrasive. And also as an eye line of, okay, I've been over that spot already. Or, okay, that spot hasn't been touched yet and it still probably has follicles under it ready to be taken. And I will usually go across or bottom to top, top to bottom, or well, top to bottom rather, on my chin, and then go that way. And that takes care of me not being able to do so smoothly this motion, because I'm still going rather thoroughly with the follicles. And then with this, with my above my lip, I just go pretty much the same. And then I'll take a hair trimmer and get rid of all this annoyance directly under my nasal cavity. And then for my jawline, I just go across one way, across the other, and get as much of that going as I can. And then I'll usually touch it up shortly after, kind of, you know, look in the mirror and go, okay, well, that's there. Need this, need that. You know, and look for as much of it to be gone as possible because dysphoria is a thing. And, yeah, this pretty much strengthens dysphoria issues for me. I want the elimination of any and all facial follicles and basically anything aside from my eyebrows and the hair on the top of my scalp. I'd rather all follicles gone. Electrolysis. It will be in my future. I will make it happen. Money will happen. I really hope it will. I also, because I am forgetful, not always attentive, and do unwell enough to neglect it, if I don't put effort to it, which I need to, I go ahead and make sure to get either corner of my mouth, and then this right here, I make sure to get that too. Because I wound up being rather ill-minded, and I will talk about it at one point, but I made a little bruise and scar right here on myself by fainting one day from not eating enough. Take your meds, eat your food, and drink your water. All that you need to. Just saying. It's my advice, and it's becoming advised by many online. I'm not going to be any different than that. And yeah, there's all this, but that's not anywhere that I'm going to shave. And there's some of it that got up here. But that's not anywhere I'm going to shave. I'm going to probably shave this little between the two and make this an actual set of two eyebrows rather than one. But I'm not going to touch this up, and I'm not going to touch this up right now on video. So that's the end of the video. Hopefully made it less than 30 minutes. And I'll talk more about some things about shaving and my thoughts on the matter of shaving, as well as products, merchandise, and other such in future videos. And also dysphoria and shaving, as well as anxiety and shaving. And maybe, who knows, at one point I'll talk about how to, on your arms, do some shaving. And perhaps, at least, if you have it in regards to your shoulder or bust, as far as shoulder up or shoulder to neck, whatever, and maybe back and maybe legs. And I'll probably leave it at that. And maybe sometime in the future I'll discuss on stomach shaving or shaving the sides of your, you know, shaving your armpits. Let's see. Yeah, I didn't show anything. But that's going to be future videos, probably. We'll see. I'll get to it. I intend to, anyways. Take care. Be well, all. Bye, everyone. See you in a future video.